How to fix high iron and calcium, low copper and magnesium without any blood donation. Hi, I'm Chris Masterjohn, and I have a PhD in nutritional sciences. I am not a medical doctor, and nothing contained in this episode may be construed as medical or nutritional advice of any kind or a substitute, therefore. This episode is meant purely as scientific education. If you wish to act on any ideas presented in this episode, please consult your physician first and never take anything herein as a reason to contradict medical advice. With that said, enjoy the episode. Harriet Knight says, I will turn 70 this year. Congratulations, Harriet, and early happy birthday. Went into early menopause at 32, experiencing extreme fatigue. I've been told that I may have too much iron, too much calcium, too little copper, too little magnesium. What choices might I have to get rid of too much iron? In these times of COVID, I'm reluctant to give blood because I may be told that I am positive. I'm not sure what alternatives I have to deal with such a diagnosis. I'm not sure. So I personally, I understand where you're coming from, and I accept your concern. Personally, speaking only for myself, I would be worried about catching COVID primarily by going a place where people were getting tested for COVID, because those are the people that think they have COVID. I actually went and got tested this week because I was in Manhattan at 9 o'clock at night and looked into City MD, and it was open, but there was no one there. So I thought, well, probably not going to get a better chance than this to go get an antibody test and not in the meanwhile catch COVID, which I think I probably had in February. So that's me. I'm not sure if you believe you would be subjected to quarantining and things forced beyond your will by getting a positive test, or you think it would be too emotionally disturbing, then makes sense not to get tested. But in terms of, and you can manage that risk however you want. If it were me, I would not have given blood a couple months ago when there was peak COVID in New York, but I would give blood now. I don't give blood now only because I'm busy. But I wouldn't be too worried about it now. With that said, I mean, honestly, I really don't. Yeah, Harriet says, I'm an emotional wreck. I live in a hotspot near Chicago. Okay, totally understood. Don't get tested for COVID. I mean, in that case, living in a hotspot and being an emotional wreck, it wouldn't even matter to me whether I was going to get tested. I just wouldn't want to be out around people. Even myself at my age. All the more so if I'm 70. So I still don't really like nutritional management of too much iron on the basis that there's no way to do it that doesn't hurt things like too little copper. Your options, I guess, are do home testing for random things that aren't COVID, but that might be a monetary expense that you're not willing to part with. You know, if money weren't an issue, I'd find a lab that would send me, actually even that is a bad idea because I'm not sure if there are any home testing kits that deal with large volumes of blood. They're probably all doing fingerprint stuff. But yeah, I mean, if giving blood is just totally not an issue, then you really your only options for decreasing iron levels are eat like a low meat, vegetarian diet, high in vegetables, nuts, seeds, and whole grains. That's probably your best bet. So a high vegetable diet is. Aaron Povman says, can green tea potentially help or does this impact copper? Well, yeah, I mean, green tea inhibits the absorption of everything that's ever been tested against. Everything that's bad and everything that was good, green tea inhibits its absorption.
But the thing is, a very vegetable-rich diet is going to be pretty high in copper. And it's going to be high in iron too, but it's going to be very poorly absorbable iron. And you know, especially if you eat a lot of whole grains, nuts, seeds, and legumes, you're going to get a lot of phytate. But you should, you know, when doing that, you should probably supplement with zinc. You could consider supplementing with copper. The preferred copper for me would be liver or liver capsules, which I think provide copper way outsized to the iron that they provide. Or Mitosynergy, what's it called? I'll put a link to the copper supplement in the show notes. It's Mitosynergy Advanced something. I forgot what the exact name of it is. That's the copper supplement that I prefer. You could also use any other copper supplement. So yeah, high phytate diet with supplemental zinc. And you will also get more magnesium that way. You can also choose to supplement magnesium. You can get supplemental phytate, but I would prefer getting it from whole foods rich in phytate. So like a very low meat, maybe vegetarian for a while, high whole grains, nuts, seeds, and legumes, high green vegetables, high diversity of vegetables, a little bit of liver supplemental, but not too much, no other meat. Potential supplemental copper, magnesium. If you don't, you know, just if you're getting too much calcium, you can cut out the calcium supplement. If you're not supplementing, you can decrease your milk consumption, your bone consumption, or your cheese consumption. If you're not consuming any of those things, they're very unlikely you have too much calcium. And that should do the trick. I mean, I think that's your best option. When you don't have giving blood as an option to get rid of iron. If needed, you can do, you know, supplemental phytate, but I would use that as the last resort rather than a first one. All right, Harriet, hope that helps.
This episode was part of a Q&A for members of the CMJ Masterpass, a buyer's club with exclusive and massive discounts on your favorite premium foods and health products, including pasture-raised and wild meat and seafood, supplements, sleep accessories, water filters, phototherapy devices, and much more. As a bonus, you also get to participate in monthly private Zoom Q&As with me. You can join the Masterpass at chrismasterjohnphd.com/masterpass and use the code Q&A, spelled out as Q-A-N-D-A, Q&A, for a 10% lifetime discount. For the remainder of 2020, I will be working full-time on finishing my Vitamins and Minerals 101 book while reserving a portion of my time for consulting clients. You can pre-order my book at chrismasterjohnphd.com/book. In my consulting, I am neither a medical practitioner nor a coach. I serve as your data analyst and your strategist. I teach you scientific principles of health and wellness, help you analyze your data, and help brainstorm actionable strategies. You can sign up for a consultation at chrismasterjohnphd.com/consultations. I will try to respond to comments here when I can, but my presence will be intermittent while I'm finishing my book. I hope you enjoyed this, and I will see you in the next episode.